Thanks for joining me as we use the free online graphing calculator Desmos to help us find the value of a couple of somewhat scary looking limits. As we can see here on the left, we have been asked to use a graphical and numerical approach to find the following limits. The limit as x approaches 0 from both sides of the function 1 plus x all raised to the power of 1 divided by x, and then the limit as x approaches negative 1 from the right. So first I'm going to use my Google Chrome web browser here, and into the URL line type in desmos.com. Desmos. Beautiful, free math. Now, there really is so much you can do with Desmos, so please explore this website as you wish. But to start graphing, click on the Start Graphing button. On this left side, we can type any function we want to graph or any value we want to calculate. So first, let's look back at our limit. We want to find the limit of the function 1 plus x raised to the 1 over x. So let's call that function y for now, and into Desmos, type y equals parentheses 1 plus x, close parentheses. You can see Desmos has graphed the line that we've given it so far. Now for the exponent, you can use your keyboard and hold the shift button while typing the 6 to get at the up arrow symbol called a caret, and that will create a superscript. Or if you didn't catch that, let me now show you the online keypad Desmos has. Down here at the bottom left side of the page is the keypad. When we click on it, voila! Which, in case you didn't know, voila is a French word that means see here. Look for a moment at this keyboard. What special button do you think we are going to use if we want an exponent? If you thought A to the B, you are correct. That button will put the cursor into the superscript position. Now we type 1 divided by x. Wow, a lot just happened there. First, did you notice that when we divided, Desmos automatically wrote that using fraction notation? Pretty cool, right? Also, we have an interesting looking graph that just appeared. What does it look like is happening to our graph as x approaches 0? It looks like it approaches the same number between 2 and 3 from both the right side and the left side. But what exactly is that number? Well, we can zoom in by clicking on the plus sign at the top right. So now I can tell it's more than 2.5. We could keep zooming in, but instead I'm going to move my mouse cursor and click on the graph. Click and hold, that is. And then I can see an ordered pair for the graph. If I keep holding and slide my mouse around, I can see other points on the graph. So let's slide over to x equals 0 and wait. We get the ordered pair 0 undefined. Now this is actually pretty important. Before, the points on the graph were solid dots, but at 0 we see an open dot. That's because there's a hole in this graph when x equals 0. Look back at our function. If we tried to plug in 0 for x, we'd be dividing by 0 in our exponent, which is undefined. So the function's domain is restricted and the whole should make sense. Okay, so how do we find that limit? We can take a numerical approach and compute the value of the function for smaller and smaller values of x as x approaches 0. To do this quickly, I'm first going to give our function a name using function notation. I'll just delete this y and replace it with an f of x. Now I can have Desmos compute f of 1 on the line below. See how it tells me it's 2? See how on the graph here I've got the ordered pair 1, 2? Now let's just change that to f of 0.1. How about 0.01? 0.001. We can just keep adding zeros until we have maybe 6 decimal places of accuracy. Like that. We can and should also check on the other side of 0. So let's also compute f of negative 0.0001. And we can always go back and add more zeros. So it looks like our limit is going to approximately equal, and I'm going to just insert a symbol, an approximately equal, and if you almost equal to. And if you don't know where that is, you can always look under more symbols and go to mathematical operators. Approximately equal to 2.71828, and those would both round to 2 for 6 decimal places of accuracy. Now, you may not recognize that number, but it's actually a special and important number, Euler's number, sometimes also called the natural number E. Now, let's say I wanted to show my work for this limit by copying this graph into my Word document. Before I do that, I want to highlight the fact that there is a hole at x equals 0. So I will create an ordered pair for Desmos to graph. I'll type parentheses 0, 2.718282 in the next line down. But I want it to be a hole, not a solid dot. To change that, I want to come up to the top and click on this Edit List, which looks like a Settings button. Come over and click on the Color, and then I can change the style to a hole. I'll click on Done. And now it is obvious that there is a hole in my graph, and that the function approaches that hole as x approaches 0 from both sides. Now, to copy this graph and put it into my Word document, there are so very many different ways you could do that. You could take a picture of your computer screen or a screenshot by hitting the print screen button, the PRTSC button at the top of your computer's keyboard, and then paste that image into the Word document. Or if you have a Windows operating system like this, you might have a snipping tool. I'll just search snip and I can use the snipping tool. I can click new and it allows me to create a box around exactly what I want to copy from my screen. I copy it with Control C. I then paste it in my Word document with Control V, like that. Using the snipping tool is my favorite way of copying and pasting an image into a Word document. But if you don't have that option, you can get the image of your graph directly from Desmos by come and click on this Share Graph button at the top right of the page and choose Export Image. Then download the GNP file. Open that image, it's probably in the downloads folder on your computer, and then copy it and paste it into your Word document. The only disadvantage is it's just the graph, it doesn't show what you typed in to actually get that graph. So it wouldn't be clear what this whole value is from just that graph. Whereas copying it with a snipping tool, I can see exactly, hey, that's the ordered pair whole that I plotted right there. That takes care of problem one. So now for problem number two. The limit as x approaches negative 1 from the right. Well, we already have the graph here of the function 1 plus x all raised to the 1 over x. So what does it look like the function is approaching as x approaches negative 1 from the right? This is negative 1. And if I click and drag, I can kind of see, well, it looks, I can zoom out even. It looks like it just keeps going up and up and goes up towards infinity. So we can also calculate f of negative 0.9. And we can keep adding nines to see that, yep, here it's at 100, 1,000, 10,000, 100,000, 1,000,000, 10,000,000, 100,000,000, and we're into scientific notation, so we can safely say that the limit as x approaches negative 1 from the right is infinity. To show that more clearly on our graph, we can have Desmos draw in a vertical asymptote at x equals negative 1. And I'm going to zoom back out. No, I'm going to zoom back in. And I'm going to, again, edit the list, come click on this color, and I want to make this a dashed line so it looks more like an asymptote. I'm going to go ahead and change this color to red so it all looks like part of the same graph. And then I'll click done. And same idea here. This is infinity, so I'm going to come into insert. I'm going to insert a symbol. I don't need an equation. I can just, again, do the infinity symbol. I want this to equal infinity. And then once again, I'm going to use my snipping tool to take a picture of what I've got here, copy, paste, to show my work.